section 10, number 570 in your hymnal. All are welcome. Number 570.
Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you all. Mass on the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. It is also our first day of classes for our children. It's also the parish picnic, and it really is a beautiful day. Today in our scriptures, you and I are going to hear the invitation to refrain from judging other people who don't think like us, right? We are going to hear the invitation that we are all called to be evangelists and prophets in our world. As we do always, we take a moment to call to mind our failings and our shortcomings. Aware that this God who loves us always brings us healing and forgiveness, and together we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. And I ask, Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. God, the Father, mercies through the death and resurrection of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. Through the ministry of the church, may God grant you pardon and peace, and I absolve you of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Together with the angels and the archangels, let's raise our voices in that wonderful hymn, the Gloria.
We give you
Pour out your Spirit, O God, over all the world to inspire every heart with knowledge and love of you. Grant that we who confess Jesus as Lord may shun whatever is contrary to this faith and give witness to your love that has saved us in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud, took some of the spirit that was on Moses, and put it on the 70 elders. When the spirit rested upon them, they prophesied. But they did not do so again. Two men remained in the camp, one named Eldad and the other's name Medad. And the Spirit rested on them. They were among those registered, but they had not gone out to the tent. And so they prophesied in the camp. A young man ran and told Moses, "Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp." Joshua, son of Nun, the assistant of Moses, one of his chosen men, said, "My Lord, Moses, stop them." But Moses said to him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the Lord's people were prophets, and that the Lord would put his spirit on them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joy to the heart. reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich people, weep and wail for the miseries that are coming to you. Your riches have rotted, and your clothes are moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have rusted, and their rust will be evidence against you. And it will eat your flesh like fire. You have laid up treasure for the last days. Listen, the wages of the laborers who mowed your fields, which you kept back by fraud, cry out. And the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on the earth in luxury and in pleasure. You have fattened your hearts in a day of slaughter. You have condemned and murdered the righteous one who does not resist you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus had finished teaching the disciples, John said to him, Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us. But Jesus said, Do not stop him. For no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us. For truly I tell you, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose his reward. If any of you put a stumbling block before one of these little ones who believe in me, it would be better for you if a great millstone were hung around your neck and you were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than to have two hands and to go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than to have 2 feet and to be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to stumble, tear it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have 2 eyes and to be thrown into hell, where their worm never dies and the fire is never quenched. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Good morning.
The readings today make me reflect about us in the American National Catholic Church. I can imagine and relate to this other exorcist in the gospel, whom the apostles tried to prevent. In our first reading also, I can also see ourselves in Eldad and Medad, who were not in the gathering, yet the Spirit rested on them as well. I remember as part of the history of the ANCC, we were given notices to cease and desist. I'm sure the word excommunication may have been thrown and or said about us. We sometimes get what millennials call today as haters. We have received numerous emails filled with negativity and condemnation. Yet amidst all this, I see the hand of God at work, molding us to be his flock, with the same mission, but with a fresh perspective of God's mercy and love. All these forces that have tried to stop us or curb us only served to enkindle in us the fire of the Holy Spirit. As first generation members of the ANCC, the journey that led us here may have begun with the experience of being rejected or frustrated with the institutional church. There were many who have been hurt by the church and have chosen to stay away from the church and the sacraments altogether. Some of us who long for the community or who miss the ancient liturgies of the church have found one another here at St. Francis. Whenever I'm being introduced as a Catholic priest in a social setting with other Catholics, I see a pattern of stories and questions. At first, when I get introduced, they tell me their involvement in the Catholic Church. Next, they ask me where I serve and if I know Father such and such. Of course, I am given a litany of names, and for the most part, I do not know them. Then I try to respond and explain that I am part of the ANCC, and we are not under the jurisdiction of Rome. And I explain to them the similarities and differences. And as I explain away, I look at their faces. Some of them I see must have piqued their curiosity. And this is usually followed by more probing questions about the ANCC. In some, I see expressions of enthusiasm and hope in their desire that we grow as a church. And I am fortunate to not have yet seen an expression of disapproval. Perhaps they're being polite. I see these events as opportunities for me to evangelize, to let people know that we exist. But there are some of us who are hurt so much by the church that have closed off their ears to any explanation. Many years ago, I remember being in a Pride Festival at the Jacob Javits Center. I was wearing my habit, and I was approached by two people in our booth and how they expressed their frustration at me and their blatant disapproval. And no matter how I try to explain myself on how we are different, they just kept going on and on and on. And I just had to listen and reflect upon their frustrations. Yes, so many have been hurt by the church. Many LGBTQ have been disowned by their own families and have become homeless in the name of God. Many have ended their misery tragically. Many have been turned away from the sacraments. And let us be mindful of what the gospel warns us, right? When we cause scandal. Sadly, this has happened and continue to happen. And that is why the Holy Spirit has given birth to the ANCC, to all of us here. We must continue to be mindful of God's love and mercy. And remember that God is beyond all of these temporal constructs. In the end of time, there will be no ANCC, no Roman Catholics, no Greek Orthodox, no Episcopalians, no Baptists, no Judaism, and no Islam. There will just be God and all of us, his children. In the name of the Father.
Let us stand and profess our faith as we say, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through God all things were made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he arose again, and was known to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As God's children, trusting in his love, we now offer our prayers and petitions.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For openness to the Spirit, that we may welcome all whom God calls to serve the community of faith in ministry, and listen for the Spirit's promptings about new forms and styles of service needed to meet the hungers of human hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been cheated or defrauded of their income, that God will overturn the injustice and provide for their needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all whose faith is weak, that the Spirit will draw them closer to God and protect them from being scandalized by the human failures within and conflicts between communities of faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the ANCC, Bishop George, Father Gidi, all our clergy, and especially our sister parish of Holy Spirit in Montandon, Pennsylvania, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of discipleship, that we may never prefer anything, even our most treasured possessions, to our relationship with Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing and renewal, that the Holy Spirit will bring healing of mind, body, and spirit to all who have experienced abuse, help their voices to be heard, and guide us in supporting them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and their caregivers, are there any whom we should especially remember? We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died and those who mourn them, are there any whom we should especially remember?
Sophia.
Rocketta. Tommy.
Laurie and Theodore.
Laurie.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
If you would join me in praying for a special intention for the parish community of St. Francis of Assisi, for this let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As always, we pray for those who have no one to pray for them. For them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Most high and glorious God, we present to you our prayers and petitions, those which you've spoken aloud and those in the depths of our heart. We ask you to hear and answer them if they be for our good, for we make them in the name of Christ your Son. Amen.
Please join in our offertory hymn, number 413, Loving and Forgiving, number 413.
Today, our school reconstituted itself, and I thought if it's not too uncomfortable for Sally and Orla and Joyce and Nate, I think if the children could join me around the altar for today to kind of represent, right? Some of your classmates have made a good escape. So come on up, yeah. Come on, sweetheart. Yeah, you can come. Come on. Not so sure. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You so loved the world that you gave your only Son as our Redeemer. You sent him as one like ourselves, though free from sin, that you might see and love in us what you love in Christ. Your gifts of grace, lost when we disobeyed you, are now restored by the obedience of your Son. And so together we join the angels and the saints in their joyous hymn of praise.
Our full of your glory.
Indeed, you are the fountain of all holiness. In communion with the whole church, we have assembled on this day which you have made holy, and rejoicing that you have made us a new creation in your risen Son, we pray, send down your Spirit upon these gifts to make them holy, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, the death he freely accepted, he took bread. He gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to all of those whom he loved, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, and handing the cup to all of those whom he loved, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in a sure hope of rising again. Bring them and all who have died in your mercy into the light of your presence. Remembering, therefore, his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord God, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you.
We pray that all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Perfect us in love. Together with the patriarchs of Alexandria, Antioch, Jerusalem, Rome, Constantinople, our Bishop George, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and all who minister to your people.
Remember our sisters and brothers who have gone to their rest in the sure hope of rising again. Bring them and all who have died in your mercy into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and with all the saints who have found favor with you throughout the ages. In union with them, may we praise you and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. My sisters and brothers, this is Jesus, our Lamb of God. This is Jesus who invites each and every one of us into the experience of God's love, and how happy are we to be called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be
healed. Here at St. Francis of Assisi, American National Catholic Church, each and every one of you are invited into full participation in the sacrament of the altar. The body of Christ brings to everlasting life.
Please join in our communion hymn, number 498, One Bread, One Body, number 498.
One God.
Let us pray. Gracious God, let this holy mystery restore us in mind and body, that we who proclaim the death of Christ and are joined to his sufferings may become co-heirs with him in glory, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for our announcement.
Please continue your support to our ministry at Pierre Toussaint Food Pantry. Sister Linda reports that weekly food distribution at the pantry continues to serve the needs of those most affected by the COVID pandemic. Any non-perishable food items can be left at the church throughout the week, and we will make sure they are brought to the pantry. Our next faith discussion group will be on October 6th at 7 p.m. Please contact Father Gidi if you are interested by sending an email to greyes@anccmail.org. We will be blessing the animals after Mass on October 3rd in honor of our Feast of St. Francis. Please bring your pets for the blessing. On October 3rd, we will also admit Jim Jakubowski and Roger Hernandez to candidacy. Mother Cheryl Smith and other clergy will also be here for this event. To foster communication and remain in touch around the country, we're holding an ANCC church-wide meeting via the Zoom platform on Saturday, October 9th, from 2 to 4 p.m. Eastern Time. Our electronic newsletter has a link to register to attend this event. If you do not receive our electronic newsletter, please contact Father Gidi. Our next religious education for children will be on October 10th at 10 a.m.
Thank you so much. I wanted to thank Melanie for her beautiful music, raising our minds and our hearts to God, right? I also want to thank Father Joseph for joining us. He's just returned from vacation, so I know he looks very rested, right? So welcome, Father Joseph. Welcome, Father Joseph. I also wanted to thank particularly Skylar and Orla and Sally and Joyce for representing. Most of their classmates got out while the getting was good. So they represented the children for us. So thank you so much for that. And thank you for helping us at the altar. In seminary, in my presiding class, I would always forget what is known as the Oratre Fratres prayer, pray brethren. And I did it again today, but I thought between Father Joseph, Father Gidi, and myself, there must be 100 years of priesthood here. And you would think that we didn't know how to say Mass. But maybe you didn't miss it. So I'm so glad that you're all here. It's good to see some people we haven't seen in a while. It's wonderful to see you. And please join us for our picnic afterwards, right? Father Joseph, I don't know if you want to say something about vocations. Father Joseph wears two hats. He's the rector of our theological institute, but also our vocation director.
So I'm going to be very brief and simply say, for some of you, vocations is not a word that you use very often, but vocation simply is a word that means call, and it refers to a call from God. And the reality is that each and every one of us has a call from God to a vocation. You don't have to wear a collar and be in religious life to respond to God's call. However, within our church, we usually refer to vocation for those who are being called by God to sacred ministry as a priest or a deacon. And we desperately need people to respond to that call. We need people such as yourselves to be alert to others in the community who might, you might think, that person might be a good candidate to be a priest or a deacon, almost a bishop. That too.
Yeah.
But if you see someone or know someone, it's important that you encourage them to think about it, because a lot of times they may be thinking about it and thinking, they're crazy. How could God be calling me to do such a thing? But if they hear from someone like yourselves, or if you yourself think you're crazy thinking about it, know that you are not, and that the church wants to encourage you. So I invite all of us to continuously pray for God's vocations within the church. God is always calling us to do work on God's behalf, and God is always in need of people to serve in the sacred ministry. And incidentally, you don't have to wait until somebody is my age or Father Gidi's age to do that. Some of our young people, including our young women, may be aspiring to be a priest or a deacon. Encourage them, support them. Their time will come with your support and encouragement. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. We have a little bit of a ringer in the parish in terms of Mary, so she's part of our formation team. When Father Joseph was deacon, many of you might remember Marco, our acolyte, and he was going off to college. And I said, Marco, well, maybe you, while you're studying at college, you might want to think about studying for the priesthood. He said, Bishop, please let me get through college, right? So he's gotten through college, but I haven't heard from him. Not true. I'm going to have a lunch with him next week. Anyway, the Lord be with you. If you stand, I'll give you the blessing. May God our Father, who has loved us in Christ Jesus, our Lord, comfort and strengthen you in every good work.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go forth from here in great peace and joy to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in our recessional hymn, number 607. How can I keep from singing? Number 607.